And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, thereafter in the next verse mentions, وَلَيْ يُؤَخِّرَ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never give respite for a person after his appointed time. When our appointed time comes, we will have to leave this world. That is why it is not behoving for a mu'min to say if and but. If this had happened, that maybe my son, my wife, my daughter, my so-and-so, my aunt should have lived. Or if this had happened, then this should have happened. No. This is opening the door of shaitan, according to the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us very clearly, وَلَا يُؤَخِّرَ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not give respite to the time, for the appointed, after the appointed time, to any soul. That includes me and you and all of us. When our time comes, we'll have to leave this dunya. And وَاللَّهُ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is fully acquainted with your actions. So here in this verse we are told that before our appointed time comes to leave this dunya, then we should prepare for the hereafter. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam exhorts us towards this, أَكْسِرُوا ذِكْرَ هَذِهِ اللَّذَّاتِ. That abundantly and excessively remember death, that the cutter off of all pleasures, yani al-maut. Abundantly think of death, because at the time of death, when we see the reality before us, a person, a young person, an old person, person that has so many ambitions, so many aspirations, so many ideas and objects in his life, we find here his life completely terminates before our eyes, and that person is gone from the dunya. Then we begin to reflect and think and contemplate that the day will come when I will have to leave this dunya in the same manner. And what preparations have I made for the hereafter? These realities are there when we see the reality of death. But before the reality of death, we find Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us that remember death excessively. Other words, that is why the mashayikh used to, one of their spiritual exercises was this for their murids, that they must sit and contemplate death at least in the day, once in a day, take out some time and complete and put out, seclude, isolate yourself and contemplate that you have passed away and now your third life has terminated. Now what have you done? What's going to happen to you after death? Thereafter sit and contemplate so that you can be spurred up, you can be jolted from the sleep and slumber, and you can wake up towards the reality of life and carry out good aman and carry out good actions. And we should remember, death is not the end of the story, but it's the beginning of the real story. Ali radiallahu anhu mentioned one day in one hadith that all human beings are asleep. Other words, when the death comes, that is when the eyes open. The eyes towards the reality of the hereafter opens after we leave this world. Our respected Shaykh always says, Dunya to bahut khushnuma thi, qabar mein jaate hi dunya ki haqeeqat khul gayi. Dunya looks so nice and rosy and so colorful, etc. The moment we went into the grave, then the reality of the dunya was opened up before us, that the dunya was nothing. It was an illusion, it was a dream. It was something that was so temporary and transitory that come and gone. The reality is this, that I have landed up here now only with my amal. The people that were most beloved to me, most cherished by me, most loved by me, they have all departed, left me here. It is only my amal that has come with me.